Inside one of the most prestigious medical institutions is the painting of a man few know much about.
Everybody go and say, who's that?
Vivien T. Thomas never had more than a high school diploma, yet most heart surgeons know his name. As a lab technician at Johns Hopkins, Thomas helped develop an operation to correct a congenital heart defect in children called blue baby syndrome.
And it was really Vivien's dedication and brilliance in the lab developing this surgery that allowed, you know, this to move forward. And so that, and it was basically the beginning of surgery on the heart.
It came with enormous challenges. Racism was a barrier throughout his career.
He was one of the 20th century's greatest surgeons, and he never operated on a human.
Vivien Thomas did receive an honorary degree from Johns Hopkins in 1976, but he didn't get recognition for much of his career.
Knowing him, he probably said something like, I fixed the heart. That would be the end of it.
But his son-in-law says he was all about heart.
I would want people to understand that he was the most kind and the most steadiest person I believe I have ever met.
It's one of the reasons he's so glad to see so much of Thomas's contributions well-preserved in the Hopkins Medical Archives.
This is the prototype defibrillator.
Vivien Thomas was part of that too. Johns Hopkins set up a fund in Thomas's name. It was established to increase diversity, but it's not the only place where his legacy lives on.
So these are x-rays so that she's able to see if the patient has any cavities in between.
Vivien T. Thomas Medical Arts Academy prepares students to enter the fields of science, mathematics, and various healthcare professions.
So students have an opportunity to get certified in a pathway in the medical field.
It offers either job training or preparation for secondary education.
So I want to be an orthodontist.
One thing that students can take away from this school is they can become whoever they want to be because the obstacles can be overcome.
Just like the man their school is named after. In Baltimore, Megan Pringle, WBAL-TV 11 News.